Good morning, children. Today in our science class, we'll see the next topic, change in states of matter. So we can change the state of matter according to their temperature. Okay, we can change a solid into a liquid or gas by changing its temperature. That is known as changing its state. So when you heat solid, no, it changes into liquid, and when you heat liquid, it changes into gas. Okay, it will be going up as a vapor. So when you cool gas, it becomes liquid, and when you cool liquid, it becomes solid. This is how you have to change the changes done in the states of matter. Some changes of states are melting, evaporation, freezing, and condensation. In melting, what happens is it will be changing a solid into a liquid. In evaporation, changes will be done from a liquid to gas or vapor. So in freezing, changes happens from a liquid to solid, and in condensation, it will be changing a gas into liquids. Okay, so we'll see matter change their states as the temperature changes. Solid changes into liquid and liquid changes into gas on heating. Gas becomes liquid and liquid becomes solid on cooling. Okay, this is what I told you. Solid into liquid means it is melting. Okay, so liquid changes into gas. Gas means it will be evaporation process will be done there. Gas becomes liquid, that is condensation. And liquid becomes solid, now it is freezing. Okay, so melting, changes of solid into liquid on heating is called melting. So if you take an ice cube, if you have kept it outside the freezer, means it will be melting. So for example, if you are keeping your ice cream in freezer, and if you are keeping outside, na, it melts, yes or no? So the temperature which is there in the freezer and outside is not the same, so it melts. So for example, if ice will be solid, is heated, it will change into water, that is liquid. Okay, next one is evaporation. Change of liquid into
vapor on heating is called evaporation. So what example we can give for evaporation is, so if you are heating the water on gas, na, you can see the
vapors coming outside, yes or no? So that is a good example for evaporation, children. So if water is heated, it will change into steam. Okay, so it gets boiled, the steam, the vapors will be coming outside, yes or no? So when your mother is cooking, you might have seen that, yes or no, children? That is evaporation. Not only in that, even seawater, all those waters are getting dried up in the summer season. Why? Because of the heat. The sun is giving the heat to the earth, so the water is dried up. Your clothes, wet clothes are dried up before evening. Yes or no, children? That is because of evaporation only. Okay, so the sun will be observing all the waters, that is evaporation. Okay, and the next one is freezing.
Change of liquid into solid on cooling is known as freezing.
So if you have water and you have to freeze that water, you will be keeping inside the freezer, sir, no? So an ice tray will be there, you will be pouring water. During that time, when you pour, it will be a liquid. So after some time, after keeping inside the freezer, after 2 or 3 hours, it will become a solid state. Yes or no? That is freezing. Okay. For example, water. It is a liquid poured in ice tray and placed in the freezer or fridge. Gets cooled and becomes ice. That will be solid. So change of liquid into solid is freezing. Then condensation. Change of gas into liquid on cooling is called condensation. Okay, so best example we can say for condensation is, I told you, for evaporation. So the waters are dried up and it is absorbed by sun. Yes or no, children? So it all those waters will be settled in the clouds. Okay, so with the cool breeze, it will be dropping, the clouds will be sending that water in as a rainfall here to the earth. That is condensation. Changes of gas into liquid. So it is going and storing. It is getting evaporated and it is going as gas. Yes or no? Water vapor. Water vapor is going there, settling there, and it is coming as rain. Rain will be a liquid. So change of gas into liquid on cooling is called condensation. For example, clouds on cooling condense and fall as rain. That is liquid. Okay, children. So one more example we can give. You are steaming idlis in the idli cooker. Yes or no, children? So the waters will be drying up on heating and it will be storing on the lid. Okay, so if you are taking the lid outside, the waters will be dropping down. That is condensation. Clear, children? Okay. So here is an activity, complete the table. State of matter is given, ice plus heat. Ice, if it is heated, what state will it give and what process it is going on there? That should be written here. Water plus heat gives you steam. What process is going on? You just find it out and write. Okay, children? Okay. So we'll go to the next topic now. Let us observe. Take a balance. What is balance? So you may have seen, no? See here, this is the balance. Keep an air-filled balloon, football in one plate and an empty football in another plate. What happens? So always the thing, object which is having weight will be going down. Yes or no, children? Air filled ball goes down. It is because air has mass, that is weight. Okay, so air is a mixture of gases. You can feel the presence of air when the wind blows. Okay, so coming to next. Materials used or not used for heating. So look at the picture, write down what you see. Wood, leaves and paper. So paper, will it burn or will not burn? Yes, it will be burning. So here, right here, paper burns. Wood, it will be burning. So wood burns here. The next, leaves also, when it gets dried up, it will be burning. Okay, so paper burns, wood burns, leaves burns. So objects, substances which is used for burning, so after getting fire, if it burns nicely, na, those things, those substances are known as fuels. Okay, So like petrol, coal, everything, so it will be used for burning. Yes or no, children? So that is fuels. Fuels. So all the machines of modern life requires energy to make them run. Yes or no? 90% of that energy comes from burning fuels only. Fuels include, I told you, petrol, coal, natural gas, etc. All these things are not only that fuels, few more things are used for burning. Paper, firewood, dried leaves and charcoal can be burnt. Liquids like kerosene, petrol and diesel also burn on heating. Domestic gas burns and helps in cooking, which we use in our daily life, in which gas cylinders. So substances when burnt give out heat, but in some substances the heat released is very low. Thus these are not used for heating purpose. Substances that give out more heat while burning are used for heating purpose. These substances are called fuels. So in this also you have three types: solid fuels, gaseous fuels and liquid fuels. So everything are used for burning. Okay, so coal, charcoal, wood, cow dung, those things are solid fuels. Gaseous fuels are gobar gas or LPG. LPG which we use, gobar gas is from the usage of cow dung. Okay, so liquid fuels, kerosene, vegetable oil, petrol. Okay children, so have you understood what I taught you today? Changes in states of matter and about the fuels. Okay, so in the next class we will start a new topic, so new unit. Okay, thank you.